So guys, so today we're going to talk about how to spot the end of the trend, and I'll give you 4 indications and confirmation so they can determine when the bullish trend is going to end and it's not just any temporary market correction. Okay, so let's get into that. Couple of important points you need to take note. First thing first, the trend can end in many, many different ways. Okay, trend doesn't just go from bullish trend and end a straight line just like that. Okay, trend doesn't end on a straight line, just understand that. Now, because when you're trading forex, you're trading the economy of the whole entire country, so it takes a lot more for the trend to end. And very often, what is going to cause the trend to end is a change in fundamentals, change in sentiment. So you gotta take note of that, especially if you're a long-term trader. Gotta take note of that, gotta learn it. Now, the first way to determine that a trend is going to end is when the price forms a lightning bolt pattern. Now, some people call this ABC pattern, 1-2-3 pattern, doesn't matter what you call it. But if you really think about it, does it look like a lightning bolt? You see? You see that? So when price does this kind of thing, this is an indication, not a confirmation. This is an indication that the price might end its uptrend. Same thing for a downtrend, okay? But please don't just use this as one factor for you to sell, okay? To add one more confirmation to this, okay, is to add this indicator called Fibonacci retracement. Add that with price action confirmation, okay? Now, how do you determine that this lightning bolt pattern is valid? When price make the first retracement, okay? Let's just label it with 1, 2, and 3. Okay, let's just label it that way for now. So what you need to do is to draw your Fibonacci from point 1 to point 2. Okay, so your point 1 would be on the 100 level, your point 2 would be on the 0 level. Do you realize that? The key thing is look at where price retraced to from point 2 to point 3. Now, how do you know the trend has ended? When price retraced from 2 to 3, if it goes beyond this level, 61.8, okay? Let's just round it up, 62%. If the price retraces and goes above 62 and then comes back down, very likely this is not a correction. If the price retraces below 61.8, and in this case it retraces up to level 50 and then comes back down, anything below 61.8, okay, when the price retraces up and then come back down from here, you know that it's going to go below level 2. You know that in this case the trend has ended. But on the other hand, when it goes above 62%, okay, if price does this thing, it comes down to level 2 and it goes above 61.8%, you know that, okay, the uptrend still has momentum to go on. The trend hasn't ended yet. This is just a bullish market temporary correction from 1 to 2. Okay, the bullish trend is still strong, it's still going on. So what do I mean by price action confirmation? If I'm to rub this thing, when the price retraces back to, let's say, level 50, you want to see preferably a bearish candlestick pattern. So basically, if you want to trade the bearish movements when the bullish trend has ended, okay, you need to be patient again. You gotta be patient. Okay, so this level 1, level 2. As you can see, price retraced back to level 3 at 50, alright? At the 50 level. So, you gotta wait for price to test level 50 and then wait for bearish candlestick signal. And then you can sell. Okay, once this red candle close, then you can sell. Alright, but be careful of this support zone right here. Okay, so what you can do is to put your stop at level 100. Okay, level 100, you can put your stop right here. Make sure you get a good risk to reward ratio. And then your TP target, you can take the level 100 to level 0. And then project your TP target down here. But if you're more conservative, you want to wait for the price to break the support zone, okay? Then you can still take a good chunk of this bearish trend, you see? Because I know that some people, they are really conservative personality. They want to wait for price to break support zone. Then in that case, feel free to do that. There's no straightforward, surefire way of trading this. There's no black and white for doing this. It still comes down to your risk appetite. I'm just giving you choices, okay? And if you watch my previous video, you also realize that there's a heads and shoulder pattern forming. So if you don't know how to trade heads and shoulder, I'll put it at the end screen at the end of this video, don't worry about that. But if you want to trade the heads and shoulder pattern, you'll want to wait for price to break below this support zone, or in this case, it's called a neckline. Then you can enter. Then you can put your TP target as that. Now, if you want a better risk to reward ratio, what you can do is that you can take this length, okay, and then times it by 1.5. Alright, you can still get a good, pretty good TP target from. Now, second way they can determine that the bullish trend is ending. So you can see that, okay, I have a price chart over here. Bullish trend, strong bullish trend, then price broke below this trend line that I draw right here. Okay, price broke the trend line and then retraces back to this trend line, which is probably going to stop a lot of people out because banks know this is where most people put their stop loss. So if you want to trade this movement, what you need to do is that, again, you gotta be patient. Don't just sell when the price break trend line, because I know most people is gonna do that when you sell here. Okay, when you sell here, you realize that a lot of times price is gonna retrace back up to the trend line. Most retail traders, they're gonna put the stop loss right here, just nice for banks to stop you out. But on the other hand, if you waited, you have a bearish reversal candlestick over here, you can sell this movement. Okay, you can sell this movement and take a good chunk of the profits. Patience pay off, my friends. A third way that you can determine that a uptrend is ending, like what I mentioned just now, a head and shoulder pattern. You have a head of a human being, which is right here, and then you have the left shoulder and then the right shoulder. Okay, this person just doesn't feel complete. Looks a bit like Donald Trump. Okay, anyway. Now again, if you watch my previous video, don't just trade and sell here when the price break below neckline. Okay, so this is the neckline. Alright. How should you trade heads and shoulder properly? If you haven't watched my previous video, first thing first, you gotta confirm that this is a head and shoulder. Of course, visually you can see it, left shoulder, right shoulder. But to really confirm it, heads and shoulder, you realize that when the head is formed, RSI would become overbought for a bullish trend. Okay? And then you realize that when it breaks neckline, you want RSI to go below 50, okay? To go from above 50 to below 50. You realize here, there's a confirmation that, okay, it's time to get in. But if you've watched my previous video, I always say that don't sell here. What you need to do is wait for price break neckline first. Then the price has to come back up, test moving average, all right? Then wait for price to come back down, break neckline once again, then you enter. Because the big players know that most retail traders is going to enter here. Agree with me? Then you can put your stop loss right here. Again, just nice for people to be slaughtered, to be killed. You don't want to fall into this trap. This is a trap, my friend. This is a trap. Wait for price action confirmation, okay? Confirm the pattern with RSI. Break up below neckline. TP target. Measure from the head to the neckline. Project it downwards, alright. Stop loss at the head, then you're good to go. Now, what's the fourth indication that a bullish trend is going to end? You can find this pattern not only in charts, you can find it when you go to Switzerland, when you go to Malaysia, Singapore, there's not a lot of mountains or too bad. Other people, they see, oh wow, beautiful view. Traders, they see, alright, let's put a straight line right here. Frustrating, right? You can't let your mind rest. Just shut up, stop thinking about trading right now. Okay, anyway, if you haven't watched my double top and triple top video I've done in the past, you know that when a double top forms, the first top, second top, okay, this increases the probability that the price is going to reverse down to a downtrend. How do you trade triple tops with confirmation? Now realize that I draw a resistance zone over here. Of course, some people will say that this is a head and shoulder. That's why I always say that it's really similar. Of course, RSI, okay, is going to go from above 70 to below 70 at the head again. Same thing. But realize something else is that there's an RSI divergence. This additional confirmation. You realize that RSI is going to slope downwards. It's going to make lower highs while price is forming the first top, or you want to call it left shoulder, second top. And then the third top, do you realize that? price is going sort of sideways, but RSI is giving you lower highs. This signal that uptrend is going to end. So how do you trade triple tops? What you want to do is wait for the breakout below support. Okay, if you're a fan of breakout, you can trade this. If you're not, then you can avoid this. When it break below support, again, I don't want you to really sell so fast. Again, you need a lot of patience. Please just practice patience. Way too many people, they're gonna sell right here, okay? They're gonna put their stop loss up here again. You're gonna get stopped out again. So what you wanna do is wait for price to break below support and give it some time to go down a little bit before it retraces back up. Now, of course, once in a while, you realize that price is going to go straight down. It's not going to retrace back up. And then you'll be like, shouldn't have waited. Careful, what are you teaching me? Of course, once you're blue moon, you're going to see that. But I'd rather be safe than sorry. You know what I'm saying? Because you don't want to trade like how most people trade. You don't want to put your stop loss at where most people put their stop loss. Now, realize that when price retraces back up, there's a bearish reversal signal. Do you realize that? Once this bearish candle close, when it confirmed, then you can make a sell. You can put your stop slightly above here, and then you can take your TP target, measure from the head until the neckline. This gives you a really tight stop. Okay, I know some people, they're gonna put their stop at the head, but if you put it slightly above the neckline when it break, it's gonna give you a better risk to reward ratio. Now, another way to confirm aside from RSI is to use MACD. Now, the principle is the same, okay? Breakout below support, like what I mentioned just now. And then MACD, divergence. Look for MACD divergence. Same thing, okay? Price making the tops or left shoulder, head and then right shoulder. Then you see that MACD is going to give you lower highs. Same thing, okay? Same thing. Don't need to care too much about, oh, what's the MACD line doing? What's the signal line doing? Just look at overall big picture of MACD. It's making low highs. Then there's another confirmation. But please don't go and clutter your chart with MACD, then RSI, then stochastics, then all the confirmation. Just pick one. Just pick one. Understand that MACD, okay? MACD does not give you a sell signal or buy signal, but it tells you that bullish momentum, bearish momentum has ended. Understand what I'm saying? So that's why please don't use MACD RSI for entry, because these are all lagging indicators. Alright, so guys, let me know down in the comment section below, how do you determine the end of the trend? How do you determine trend changes? So if you want to check out my MACD video, RSI video, I'm gonna put in the end screen. So with that, I'll talk to you in the next video. Bye.